Hello everyone, this is HPI Guys Model Workshop coming at you again with another styrene kit review. This is the Civil War Confederate Horse-Drawn Field Artillery Kit available from Lindberg. I picked this kit up from Tower Hobbies on their inventory reduction sale, and I check that sale on their website just about every single day to see what's on sale. When this came up on sale, I just about fell out of my chair. This kit is enormous. There's my hands in the center of the box. You can see the size of that thing. That box is about 2 feet long. The kit itself is 2 feet long to 2.5 feet long when you're done assembling it. It's a monster size kit. They advertise it as 1/16th scale, but as I'll show you, in my opinion, I think it's more like 1/12th scale, just a little bit bigger, but it could go either way. It's been available from Lindberg for a very long time. The lowest price I've ever seen it for online shipped is around $75. This came up on Tower's inventory reduction sale, brand new in the box, sealed, for under $29 shipped. I paid $28.78 to get it to my home. Even if you're not a big figure model kit, you can't say no to $50 off an amazing kit. There's tons of parts in here you could use for other things. The theme is really cool. There's a matching set of figures and another artillery set for the Union side, so you could build two of these. They did have the Union one on sale, but it barely got below $50, and then it went right back to normal price. So I would have liked to get that one, but I'll wait and keep seeing if that one drops in price as well. But since Round 2 owns Lindberg now, they're going to keep making these. They're going to keep putting them out. You can see that this is made in the USA, like Lindberg kits. They are injection molded and packed in the United States. This is a skill level 3 kit. You can see, we'll get that way up there. You can see some of the details on the box. The actual assembled kit is right there. And the pictures are so big and the boxes are so big that it's hard to get it all on camera. You can see when it's assembled, it will be about 31 inches long. Includes 4 horses and hitch chains, the cannon, the accessories for the cannon and the wagon. It includes figures and just about everything else you need to put this together. And let's start taking a look at everything. First thing up is you are going to get 4 horse figures. And they are in 2 different poses. I'm going to put them out here. You can see you get 4 horses in 2 different poses, which allows you to do a realistic look at the kit. And some of these will stand up on their own, and these ones here are more made to lean back as if they were, you know, pulling hard or resisting their reins. You can take a look at the size of those things. That's me holding one right there. That's a pretty big horse. I've never painted a horse before, so that's going to be a treat to paint these all different colors, because not every horse was identical looking. It's nice molding. The seams are in a good spot for the most part, so you can see that it won't be that much of a big deal. Horses are pretty smooth. They're not super hairy, so you'll be able to take care of that pretty easily. And they rubber band them together from the factory, so you make sure you have each half in there correctly. So let's get those out of the way. The 3 figures included in the kit are these guys right here. And you've got 2 soldiers sitting, one on either side of the wagon. If he's going to sit up, he's had a little too much ale. And then you've got the guy who's straddling one of the horses with his sword. The sword's a little wonky. They've been making these for so long. You're just going to have to expect stuff like that. But they've even got his scabbard, and he's molded pretty nice. He looks kind of angry. Kind of a cool guy, though. I mean, he was Confederate, but who cares? That's a long time ago. But he's got his canteen on him, and this is a solid figure. So no seams to clean up except for the injection seam itself, which, as you can see, we'll get in there close. Isn't bad. That's going to sand right off, and you're going to be able to not have to lose any important details. And the other 2 guys are just close mirror images of each other for sitting on the wagon. They both look good. They're solid. They're one piece. Things look straight. They don't look ridiculous. Their hats look good. They look the part. One guy's got a beard. This guy doesn't have a beard. He's pretty new. He's the FNG in the unit. So he's going to be riding shotgun on the wagon, hanging on for dear life as they go into battle, pulling the cannon. One of the things they include in there is a lot of accessories to rig the horses up. That's one of the biggest things in the kit. They include this big, nasty mess of vinyl. They include some very nice brass chain or brass colored chain to do a lot of the riggings and the bridles for the horses. And they include two Confederate flags, because this is the Confederate Army, so they're going to have those on there if you want it to look authentic. And no opinions, please, in the comment section about Confederate flags or anything else. It's just a model, so let's have fun just looking at it. Take those out of the frame. This I would recommend. It's, I mean, it's really bent up and coiled. I would recommend clipping a weight on the end, like a couple heavy clamps, and hanging it from a ceiling and running a hairdryer over it very lightly, and that should straighten it right out. Just the weight itself and running it through your fingers should straighten it out nice and well and make it easy to work with. Now, the directions here are classic old school Lindberg, and you could take a look. They market these all over, so you've got some French in there. And the secession, or, you know, the Civil War, the Confederate succession. And then they explain with drawings and words how to put this together. And I've never assembled a kit like this. I've had my eye on these and the other Lindberg Western kits that I'd love to take a look at. So this ought to be a lot of fun. There's not a huge amount of drawings, and there's a lot more writing than you're used to. So you're going to have to use the pictures a lot. You're going to have to reference the box if you're not into following directions in print. And that's just a nice little booklet that goes all the way through. You can see how intense the rigging is going to be on these horses. How you're going to have to get involved, and you're going to have to do that four times and then join it all together. So that's no joke. There are numerous steps to taking care of that. And on the back, then they show you how to rig everything together. And tell you how to place the soldiers on, how to deal with all the different things you have to deal with on this kit. It's a large kit. It's very extensive. You're going to just have to put it together and deal with it, but the end result is worth it. Now, the parts included are quite small on some of the trees, and they include big parts and little parts on the same trees. So I'm going to leave everything in the bags, but you're going to get a good view at it because the camera does film in HD. So you're going to be able to pick up everything in here. But you can see many of the riding accessories, the tackle and hardware, and I'm not a horse farrier, so I don't know the exact terms for all these things, but you're getting a good look at it and everything that's involved in there, and those tiny, tiny parts. For being as old as this kit is, Lindbergh's still putting it together well. They're still molding it well, not a huge amount of flash. Here's parts for the wagon. You're going to have to do a lot of wood painting. That's the forget exactly what they call what a cannon sits on. Is that called a blockade? I'm not really sure. But that's what the cannon sits on. And there's the cannon itself. And you can see down here the size of that. That is about 5 inches long, 5 1/4 inches long. So it's a nice piece of hardware. And the very large wagon that it rides on. You can see the sides to the wagon. You can see I'm forgetting what everything is called today. This is what they stuff down the cannon barrel to pack the ball and pack the powder in. And I cannot remember the name of it. So tell me in the comment section, or it'll drive me nuts. Here's some of the larger pieces you'll see. These are the huge wheels for the cart. And they're all molded in one piece with most of their hubs. You can see the hubs are a little loose down here. But for the most part, they're all together for you. So you don't have to try to assemble all those spokes. And you don't have to try to deal with that. Which, trust me, if you look at one of my other reviews for the beer wagon, you're going to see how complex they could have made it on you, and instead they injected it in one piece. And those wheels themselves on the board there, you can see are just under 5 inches across. So it's going to be just a huge kit when you're done. This is some of the work for the wagon. You can see the back door of the wagon, the tailgate. You can see a lot of the wood bracing for the block and tackle for the horses. You can see it's all molded nicely. Get out your washes, get out your stains, get out your airbrush. You're going to have to make this all look like wood and fabric. That's the nice seat done very nicely. Molded really nice. Looks like someone's going to be sitting on there. So that's very well done. You're going to have to do a lot of work to get this to look like real wood with metal strapping going through it. This one here is a huge bag, and this is the last bag we're going to look at. This is all the tackle for the horses, and there's four sprues in here. You can see all four. And this monster amount of plastic, you can see how super, super thin that is. Let's see if I can get it on edge here. You see how thin all that plastic is? And that's why I don't want to take it out of the box, because I don't want to break it until I'm actually going to build it. But these are what you're going to have to assemble around the horses. You're going to have to paint all these parts. I recommend doing it on the tree as much as possible, then gluing them together, then just finishing up with a brush and finishing up the glue areas, because this is going to take a lot of work. I wouldn't be surprised if the tack for the horses took a couple weeks on its own, just to get everything perfect, get it on the horses, get it arranged nicely, and make it look good. But if you work at it and you take your time and you get out the leather paint and you get out the washes and your stiff brush for dry brushing, it's going to look beautiful. You can reference some other videos on YouTube about how to paint styrene to make it look like wood. Classic Plastic 101. Chris did a great video when he did the Atlantis Blackbeard figure, and he did a wood deck on that, and he made it look complete. You would have thought it was made out of a chunk of oak. And I think you should take a look at that video, the Atlantic Blackbeard Pirate by Classic Plastic 101, for tips on how to paint this to look like leather and how to paint the wagon parts here to look like wood. When you're all done, you're going to end up with a very nice looking kit. When you're all done, it should look a lot like that. And you can see how well they have it done with all the different colors of horses. And you could take different pictures of horses or look at them on the internet to see exactly how you want it to look. So you see, when you're done, that's going to be a beautiful kit. All you have to do is provide your own base. The base is not included, but a wood plank, a 1x8 would be beautiful for that, and just some ground cover on it, and you'd have yourself a beautiful kit. If you can find this kit for the price that I did, for $29, don't hesitate. Whip out the checkbook. Buy it today. For $79, I still think it's a lot of plastic and it's a beautiful kit. I would pay it if I really, really wanted this kit. But when I saw it on sale, I had to get it. And if you can find it on sale, I recommend you get it as well. Thanks for watching.